Da-da-da-da-da, today is a good day, I'm feeling great. Ba-ba-da-ba-ba. Oh, what a great day. I'm so happy because I'm a gummy bear, gummy bear. Oh my god, the lights!
You missed the exit sign. It's all falling apart now. Cause we were doing fine until you messed it up and our very special guest referee, very tough, very comfortable, and very classy, Samantha Foxy.
Thank you, Ryan.
Oh, now you're Brian. You used to be BK. I liked you better as BK, by the way.
Like I said, I don't wake up every morning and turn over and kiss you on the cheek looking for your approval.
Yeah, that's why you call me every morning and say, hey, Paul, you like me today? And I just hang up the phone.
Actually, what it is, you got my voice on recording. You're just playing an old voicemail where I said, I don't like you, and you clipped it.
Okay. That's all. Anyway, we have a great night of action here at Fusion Pro Wrestling. Big matches. Let's start them off. We have the debut of Joanne.
Hold on. We got something going on.
What's going on now? Whoa!
It's closing to the dick.
Oh, Jesus. Wow.
I wasn't expecting this.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the ring at this time, the last Irish outlaw, Baza Winlow!
What a surprise here to start the show.
Yeah, but apparently there are some people who don't really care for him. I've seen a few, choice words thrown forward by
Well, you know what, DK? Them people are idiots. Okay, them people are idiots. Let's see what Boss has got to say before these people make an opinion.
Okay. Maybe somebody cut his mic. I mean, if Nicole thinks that much of him, maybe this is the best he's heard that she's ever sounded to her.
Wow.
I mean, we got several microphone ears.
Yeah, Drew, go over and give him my mic.
Wow, Boz is all over Drew right now.
Come on, Drew, do your job right.
I'm giving the man a microphone. Keep your skirt on.
Oh, this one works. This fucking one works, right? You know, maybe the Tech Monkeys finally got my headset working. So, as I was saying, some of you know me, some of you don't. So, for those that don't know me, let me introduce myself. I am the last Irish outlaw, Baza Winlow. That name sounds familiar, but I guarantee you know my work. Because let me tell you a little story. 10 years ago, to the day, last week, was my first contract in SL Wrestling. And ever since then, I have innovated. I have made people's dream lists of matches. I've been put on Mount Rushmores of wrestling. I have innovated moves that people have stolen. I have literally seen imitation after imitation after imitation. In fact, there's an imitation right now on Twitter calling himself the best. Guess what? 2013 Basil look. Slick back hair, man bun, bandana, beard, fuck you attitude. But, you know, that's all me. So why am I here? Why did I join? Because after 10 years, I could have retired. But I don't like posers. I hate posers. I hate people who call themselves stuff that just isn't true. Look at Curt Bombastic. He calls himself the King of Strong Style. He's a bitch. He's just a bitch. So I'm here just to prove that I am simply the best. And I am often imitated but never replicated. But if anybody knows me, when I sign somewhere, I do not sign alone. And you will see some of my very close friends very, very soon. And we're going to fuck shit up. I hit my fucking music.
Wow. Big words.
Wow. I am liking this guy already. He called you boy Kurt. He called you boy out.
Gotta love that attitude. Well, we'll see about that. You know, it's pretty easy calling somebody out when they're in the ring. You know, when the other person's on there looking at you in the face. Let's see what he has to say then.
Well, Kurt was in the back. Kurt could have come down here and gotten his face.
Kurt's getting ready for his match tonight, BK.
Well, Kurt is as great as you claim that he is. Having two matches in one night is no big deal for him.
Anyway, go ahead, Drew.
When the music hits, we'll get the introductions underway.
Oh. All right, then. Anyway, our first match tonight's going to be a good one, PK, because we talked about it during the pre-show. Joanne Steele versus Attitude. I'm really looking forward to this match.
Do we want to do some prediction?
I don't do this for the
absolutely.
Riches. I'm infected. My condition is I'm always in my head.
What's your prediction, Sammy? What do you like in this match?
I'm obsessed. It's by decision. I'm going to do this till I'm dead.
Oh, God. See, me and Samantha are not going to agree on anything. Oh, here she comes right now.
Somebody's not agreeing with you. Oh my God.
Our opening contest for the evening is Superman Fall. Introducing first, making her FPW debut. She stands 5'9" tall and weighs at 166 pounds. Hailing from Forest Hills, Queens, New York, USA, Joanne Steele.
Yeah, she has a tough road ahead of her.
Hello, Joanne.
I'm worried about me.
I'm loving Joanne more and more every single week.
Absolutely out. Typical New Yorker.
But aren't you from Pennsylvania? Aren't you a northerner as well?
Yeah, but we're more polite than the New Yorkers.
But, you know, it's really funny that you're sitting there saying, you know, that you and Sam are not going to get along because she doesn't agree with you. What are you going to try to do? You're going to try to be a part of the cancel generation? You're going to try to be part of the cancel generation now and not be friends with her because she doesn't agree with you?
Have you
going
to cancel her opinion? Along? I just said we weren't going to agree with everything.
And introducing her opponent. She stands 5'10", tall and weighs 156 pounds. From Great Yarmouth, North England, she is the Monster, Abbie.
used to call people names when they're sitting over here behind this nice cushy desk. Which is what you do quite a bit of. They pay me to do it. They pay you to do it. Before this match gets started, let's go ahead and get a few things about this match so that everybody is all caught up. Joanne is actually making her FPW debut, so this is the first match that she has. So I personally hope that she actually like Joanne. This is the first meeting ever between Abbie and Joanne. As many feds as they've both been in, this is the first time they've ever met, so this is going to be very interesting to see what happens since they don't really know anything about each other's style other than what they've seen on video.
Don't forget to mention, too, and maybe Sammy can help us with this. Who did Abbie defeat last week? I'm just curious. Who did she beat last week? Any guesses?
Yeah, she defeated me.
Ah, that's what I thought.
But don't leave out the part that she had help.
Oh, God. You know, a win's a win, BK. I don't care if there's help. A win's a win, okay?
Okay, so I'm going to remember that when Joanne challenges you to an intergender match and I hop in the ring and I kick your teeth down your throat and she gets the pin, a win's a win.
Why would you hop over the ring and kick my teeth down? What did I do to you?
You're breathing.
Jeez. Let's go. Ring the bell.
Oh, Abbie.
You're not in a match.
Oh. All right, here they go. Oh, and went to offer a handshake, and Abbie just slapped her in the shoulder.
So naive of Joanne to do that. Come on.
See, Joanne is not backing down. Oh, Abby's got her with an eye rake.
It was Irish ripping in the corner. See, I don't know if Joanne. I've seen Joanne in many matches, BK. I don't know if she's ever faced the likes of Abbie Toot. I really don't know she's ever done that. This is a huge challenge for her. And if she can somehow, by miracle of whatever, pull off the victory here, it'll be a big victory for Joanne.
Well, it may also be a big victory for Abbie if she can pull it off. Because like I said before, these two have never met in the ring, so they know absolutely nothing about each other. So whoever pulls this one off, they're definitely going to earn it. Because they have nothing to go by. They have no history.
Well, I'll tell you what, Abbie Toot's really bringing it to her in that corner over there, going all the way to the four count with that foot choke.
Yeah, unfortunately, you got to the count of five, so a lot of people take advantage of it, and that's exactly what Abbie did.
An exploder! An exploder by Abbie Toot! And Joanne Steele already, in the beginning of this match, is in trouble in her debut match.
Yeah, but you can't count Joanne out.
Oh, and a headbutt. Headbutt drops, going for the pin. Come on, ref. One. Two.
Oh. Just a one count.
Oh, look like a two count to me.
Well, that's why you're not a ref.
At least I can count to three.
Yeah, but you got to... How do you count to three by your fingers? Because like I said before, we know you can only count to 21 when you're in the shower.
Well, I got 10 fingers, and I could count three of them if I needed to.
Okay.
Abbie
worries so much about Abbie is out here just yelling at people, are you entertained? She needs to keep her eye on Joanne. Give Joanne an opportunity, she will take advantage of it.
I mean, Abby's an entertainer too. I mean, she's a circus. She's good from the circus. Of course she entertains. She wants to entertain all these useless people.
Okay. But I'm still pulling for Joanne.
Nice spine buster out of nowhere.
Nice spine buster. Basically, that was almost like a modified power bomb the way she brought that down.
One. Oh, two count. Got her on a two count. I think Abbie too was a little surprised by that quick move there by Joanne.
I told you don't count Joanne out.
I'm counting her out because I want her out. How about that?
You know what? I'm going to laugh when Joanne comes over here and slaps that twat knot off your head.
Yeah, well, you know, she made a little mention of that on social media. And you know what? I got my lawyers all ready for that in case that ever happens, BK.
Ooh, that was a vicious spear.
Yeah, I caught that.
That was very vicious. I've been on the receiving end of a few of those, and they do not feel good. I'm sure you have too, Sam. I'm sorry, Samantha.
No, I can tell. If you get a spear, especially like that, you will feel a lot of hurt.
Oh, yeah, because it knocks the wind right out of you. And Abbie is actually doing the right thing right here. She's actually gut punching.
Oh! Tiger driver!
She was actually gut punching on Joanne, make sure that she kept her air knocked out of her after hitting her with that spear. So that was very smart. Can't breathe. You can't move. You can't fight if you can't breathe.
That was a nice tiger driver, though, by Abbie, too. And she's in full control right now.
And Abbie is not liking how ref is counting today.
I was counting two, and she was only at one, so she is a little slow.
Yeah, but your count doesn't really matter to anybody, so.
There's Joanne with some chops.
Yep, got her back in the corner now. She's cut the ring off. Oh, nice high knee right to the jaw.
Yeah, Joanne turned this match around. Now Abby's in the corner. Gets her in a nice headlock, side headlock here. Trying to move her away from that corner.
Yep, can't beat him in the corner. And do not get him, and, you know, don't get counted out.
Oh,
nice vertical suplex. Holding her up there forever.
Oh, holding her. Go ahead, BK. I'm sorry.
No, I was just going to say that she was letting all that blood rush to her head. When Abbie comes down, she is going to be in la-la land. She's going to be so dizzy.
I mean, Joanne Steele must have been working out, man. I've never seen this type of strength on her before in any of the other previous matches I've seen her in.
That's because you were too busy working on your cheesy pickup lines for her. We know you have a...
Yeah, I have many of them.
Oh, you have many secret crushes on Joanne? Yeah, that's not surprising.
I don't really have a crush on Joanne. Give me a break.
Joanne whips Abbie into the corner very hard. Abbie actually come off her feet a little bit. She got whipped, so uh-oh. Joanne's taunting.
Well, I've seen this backfire on many, many of superstars in the past, BK.
Abbie backing up all the way across.
She's really going to call for a finish.
She let Abbie come out, and Abbie caught her. Jeez. I don't think I've ever seen a move like that.
Joanne was set. Well, Joanne was setting her up for her corner kick that she uses as her signature move before her, you know, her big move, that Coney Island Express or whatever the hell she calls it. But that's what usually was her before her signature move for that. And Abbie, too, had that scouted perfectly.
Kudos to Abbie for having that one. Uh-oh. Abby's talking smack now. Ooh. She just called Joanne a freak and told her it was time to die, and she goes to an eye rake.
Oh, the freak spectacle. That's her finisher right there, BK. He's going for the pin. One.
Two. Only a two count.
Joanne kicks out at about 2.8 there. Joanne kicks out. And Abbie Toot is really mad now.
And Joanne is just right now, she's, like I've said it before, and like I said, you know, Samantha, she can attest to this. Right now, she's probably just running on instinct. She probably has no idea where she's at. Her body is just trained so well that she heard the ref's hand hit the mat. She heard the two, and she knew she had to get out of it.
Yeah, absolutely. I can tell as a debut, Joanne is going very well.
Yes.
Well, she's not going right in the well now. Her back's on the mat. She's looking at the lights right now.
Abbie's not happy about it. She is just stomping a mud hole in Joanne right now. Oh, now she's using her foot, choking her on the mat.
Oh, come on, ref.
And she's laughing about it.
Yeah, what, she's yelling, what are you going to do? She ain't going to do nothing. She got till five.
Yeah, but to sit there and be laughing at the fact that you're choking your opponent, you basically choking the life out of your opponent, that is deranged.
I don't know if that's deranged. She wants to win.
It's one thing to win. It's one thing to put your opponent out of commission.
Out of misery? Say, out of misery?
Out of commission. If we want to put anybody out of misery, we just take that twat knot that you have and use it as a ball gag and stuff it in your mouth.
That's weird. Ball gags. Come on.
Oh, Joanne just laid out Abbie.
A European uppercut.
Caught her off guard, and I think Abbie is probably saying, where am I at right now?
Abbie didn't see that coming at all.
Oh, nice.
That's a Fosbury flop there, BK. One, two. Oh, and Abbie kicks out.
Wow, that moves. Who was it last week? Was it Brooke that did that move that we had no idea what happened?
It was so fast we couldn't even see how it went.
And that's exactly what Joanne just did. I saw her hit Abbie, and then I looked up again, and next thing I know, she got her in a three count. I didn't even see what she did. Or got her in a two count, actually. I got a pin.
Abbie Two's wondering where she's at. I mean, this match has been back and forth. Joanne Steele's has been, I have to admit, somewhat impressive in her debut match here, Fusion. Oh, she's setting her up for now.
Uh-oh, Joanne's yelling that it's over. Uh-oh. Can Joanne pick up a big, huge victory on her debut? Uh-oh. Hits her up and hits her with Coney out of Wonder Wheel.
And that's her finisher.
Goes it to it. One, two, three.
Here is your winner, Joanne Steele!
Holy Isle of Wonder Wheel. There's your winner, Joanne Steele. I think she's surprised she even won the match. Look at her. Oh, now she's pawing that. Come on.
You're complaining because she's taunting, but it was okay that Abbie called her a freak and told her it was time to die.
Well, Abbie, there was no lies told in what Abbie said.
Well, actually, it was because she told Joanne, now die, freak. You see, you got the victory, so that was it true.
Yeah. I guess we're going to continue seeing Joanne Steele amongst us here at Fusion Pro Wrestling. She'll beat our match one day for sure, BK. You mark my words, she'll beat our match one day.
I believe it will be a very interesting intergender match, seeing Paul versus Joanne.
Hold your horses there, Samantha. I get paid to commentate. I don't get paid to wrestle. I get paid to tell it like it is, sitting in this chair behind this beautiful desk.
Video.
All right, guys. Speculate, right? I mean, it could either...
I'm not speculating. I have no idea what that was.
Wow.
I have generally no idea, too.
I'm clueless, to be honest, but I will be thinking about that constantly.
Constantly? All right. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Let's get ready for our next match. Take it away, Drew. coming out next on the UK.
Tall and weighs in at 245 pounds. Hailing out of Toronto, Ontario, Canada, he is the irresistible one, Curt Bombastic!
All right. Maybe we need to get the shot back. Maybe sitting in the wet spot or something. Oh, Curt Bombastic!
Oh, good Lord, I have never seen somebody go gaga so much over a performer.
I wouldn't say gaga, I'm happy to see him. I'm really interested in this match.
Introducing his opponent. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall and weighs in at 210 pounds. Hailing from Bognor Regis, West Sussex, England, Bobby Henderson.
It wasn't easy, but nothing is. No.
You know, I'm not gonna lie. I have to go back to Bobby.
When I was young.
Why do you feel bad for Bobby?
Well, I mean, last week he was in here and, well, I mean, he got
decimated. Say it.
Yeah, he did. He got decimated while, you know, and this week he's got Curt Bombastic. I mean, did Bobby do something to tick the Booker off or something?
Oh. Hey, he's in the ring with Curt Bombastic now. BK, and you know what that means.
Yeah, I know.
Idiot King of Strong Style, Mr. Irresistible, Kurt Bombastic.
Okay, why don't you go ahead and call Chapstick and tell them to send your whole crate over here because you're going to be kissing his butt the entire match.
You know who I hope's watching this match? Mr. Acidar back there who's trying to earn the respect of the man Kurt Bombastic right now.
Well,
hopefully he's watching back there.
Samantha, help me out on this one. Tell me, is it not easier to earn somebody's respect by doing it in the ring as opposed to doing what Paul's trying to do and trying to get the respect of Curt by being his biggest fangirl?
Well, I can tell in general it's not easy because you have to earn the respect of your opponents. So if you get the respect of somebody like Curt Bombastic is really a big thing.
Yep.
You know, and Curt Bombastic said to me last week, he said, you know what, Paul? You're my favorite commentator. And I was flattered that he said that.
Curt must have been to the doctor and got some kind of injection of painkillers or something because nobody would ever tell you that intentionally.
Wow. He did. Next time I'm going to take a video of it on my iPhone. And here we go. He's got him in a lockup arm lock here. Curt Bombastic ready to put on a clinic here. So that's what he's going to do, BK. He's going to put on a clinic.
Well, like I said, okay, so that he went to the clinic. He got a shot. He was high on painkillers after, you know, out here last week, you know, straining his neck to get a good look at his number one fan, which is you.
Oh, you hear that chop?
Yeah,
what
I heard it.
What a chop echoing through the arena here. Oh, and another one. Poor Bobby got to be on the receiving end of them vicious Canadian chops.
Dude, I'm just going to go ahead and I'm just going to book the wedding venue for you and Curt. I mean, might as well.
Hey, I enjoy his work.
Nice.
I didn't say I wanted to marry him.
Anyway, ref gets on to him, tells him to pull it out of the corner. He gets Bobby out. Bobby catches him with a kick to the gut, whips Curt over to the corner very hard.
Oh, we seem we got a reaction from Bobby.
Finally.
I tell you, Bobby's the little engine that could. He gives it all he can, but he just can't finish.
Oh, look at that. Huge corner splash and then a monkey flip.
Yep, and you see who is fighting for air right now, don't you, Paul?
Yeah, I see it. So the match ain't over yet, BK. Hold on, just calm down.
I'm good. Bobby whips Curt. Curt comes off the ropes.
Oh,
oh nice hurricanrana. Goes into a quick pin. One, two, and... Oh.
Oh. Only a two count. Ooh, that was about a 2.8, 2.9,
that
almost.
Close.
You almost very, seen very, the very. First victory of Bobby Henderson there.
Yeah, wouldn't it have been something for him to beat Curt right here in front of you?
It would have been nothing more than a fluke, I'm sure.
And now Bobby is stalking him. Wait for Curt to get... Oh! Curt used his own momentum and caught him with a snap roundhouse kick, and now Bobby is in La La Land.
Not yet, sir. Not yet, he said to Bobby Henderson.
Oh, yeah. Ooh! Wow.
Series of kicks here. Oh, and some vicious knee strikes.
Straight into a suplex. He went for all the cravati, or was it, how's it pronounced, cravati?
You could say it, yeah. Sure.
Okay, cravati knees and strikes right into a snap suplex, and... I think Bobby's having flashbacks from last week. Poor guy.
I don't think Bobby knows where he's at right now. He don't even know where the ropes are to help him get some momentum to get on his feet.
Well, considering the fact what happened last time he used the ropes for momentum, I don't think he'll want to do that again. And Kurt's actually letting him get up. Is Curt toying with him?
Oh. Curt knows where he has Bobby right where he wants him.
Oh, and Curt comes out and tried to get him with another roundhouse, and Bobby actually rode under it.
Off the ropes.
Oh! Curt come off with that shotgun morbid kick. Caught Bobby right in the mouth. Uh-oh.
What's
He's
this?
He's not playing around. He's taunting Bobby to get up.
Oh, my God. I don't see it well for Bobby.
I think Curt is about to end this one.
He's setting him up.
Hey, wait a minute. Whoa, wait
a
minute.
He just did a version of Matt Asador's finisher, BK.
Did he just steal somebody else's finisher?
Talk about disrespect. He didn't steal anything.
Then
okay.
What would you go? Oh! It Curt gets it with the irresistible ending and goes into the...
And that'll do it. Stick a fork in him. Bobby.
Curt needs to be brought up on charges. That is theft. He just stole somebody else's move.
He didn't steal anything. He did a version of Matt Asador's finish. He didn't steal it. He made his own little twist to it and did it. I don't know what you're talking about.
Here is your winner, Bombastic.
Yeah. So how would you take it, Paul? If let's say that Curt was in a match with somebody. And they use that his finisher move. What would be the first thing you'd say? They can't do that. That's not their move. That wasn't his.
Wow.
That was straight up highway robbery.
He's showing who can do it better. And apparently, Curt Bombastic can do it way better than Asador.
My God. Are you going to start singing whatever you can do, I can do better for him?
I'm not singing that. That's what he just actually just did.
Oh, God.
Anyway. We have to get
Samantha.
A quick...
Dad. Samantha, I'm so glad that you're out here so I got somebody intelligent to speak to.
Hold on. Anyway, I have to agree. Even then, what happened, I'm quite sure what has happened because I'm sure there will be a reaction in some way from him.
We'll see. Anyway, we got to do some plugging here. We'd like to thank a quick shout out to everyone who has helped make the first ever Fusion Pro Wrestling show take place here tonight. And thank you all in the crowd for showing up. It really does mean the world to us. We also like to thank our partners who have helped us starting out and helped us all along our journey. I'd like to shout out a quick thank you to WPWF. Catch their shows every Saturday at 6 p.m. SLT time at the Career Sim. OEW, who will be making their grand return this Sunday at 2 p.m. At 11 a.m. SL time. Don't want to miss that. And, of course, Smart Tees, our official supplier of our merchandise for FPW, as well as MMA gear. Here's the mesh design by Maddie and Classic. And don't forget, for all you fans out there, pick up a shirt like the one I have on here of my favorite wrestler, DHA, right in the back of the entrance. Pick up your favorite T-shirt and enjoy yourself just like I am with my DHA custom-made T-shirt that was gifted to me by my favorite wrestler, BK.
So you have a customized DHA shirt that only...
If you read the back of it, it says, to Paul, the best announcer, the best commentator in SL Wrestling, your favorite wrestler, DHA. That's
you know what? Says. I'm not even going to ask how in the world he was able to write that on the back of
Must
your
be
shirt.
Be in microscopic font.
I'm not even going to ask how he was able to write that
here.
On the
you
back of
see.
Your shirt.
You guys are just jealous. That's all it is. Well, hold on. We're getting another video for the back. Okay? Not like a video. Candy.
Wow.
Now let me paint y'all a picture. Fox pimp hard, just quiet like a whisper. Don't get it mixed up. Bad little sister, not bad meaning bad, but bad meaning good. Damn, I'm so good. You should see me in jeans. It's hard to describe.
Oh, Kandy Perez.
I might stop the holler and pop my collar. Maybe a little conceited, but that's always needed. Love attention when I'm passing by. See, I show a little cleavage.
And by the way, Paul, we also know for a fact that the only reason why he actually signed your shirt like that is because it's written in crayon, because he knows once you watch it, it's going to come off, so he only wants you to feel good for about 15 minutes. He threw his hand on my
waist, looked in my face, and said, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Kandy Perez.
Oh, this is a surprise, DJ. Kandy Perez is here. You had something to say.
And she wasn't here. Now just imagine why is she here? Stretched out. I'd be all over the news if this takes out. So
hopefully Drew gave her a working microphone.
All right, Kandy says, first off, I'd like to thank the UK for giving me such a warm welcome. And she continues, now, you guys know I'm not one to talk much. However, I feel like there's something that I'd like to get off my chest. She says, a lot of people are asking me, well, Kandy, why are you here? And she continues, I would say Fusion Pro Wrestling has some of the best wrestlers in SL.
I cannot disagree with that.
Yeah, I would have to agree with that statement too. She says, I could say this place brings me a lot of opportunities. But no. That's not why I'm here. She says, I'm not here for the guts, the glory, the black, or the green. I'm here for the gold.
Oh, interesting.
That's right. The Rainbow Goddess is here to add gold to her set. So whether I have to earn it or get an opportunity, it doesn't matter. Because here, I'm just going to take it. Well, some mighty bold words considering the competition that she has around here, you know, including the lady here, my, you know, right here on my left-hand side. She's saying she's going to take it.
She's putting everybody on notice.
Well, I mean, that's fine, but not going to be easy.
What do you have to say to that, Samantha?
It's never easy to be climbing from the big mountains.
I don't know how to take that comment. Somebody just yelled out, everybody is going to get a piece of candy. So I'm not sure how to take that.
Well, I think she put everybody in that locker room, every woman in that locker room on notice, BK.
Now, instead of me flapping my gums, I'd rather show you all what I can do and will do in this ring. So I look forward to taking down whatever woman is ready to step in my way. Well, Sam, I wonder if that's pretty much her issue in an open invitation. I wonder if you accept that, if she's going to turn you down as well. And Kandy finishes off with, she can't wait.
I'm looking forward to seeing Kandy in the ring. I mean, she had big words there, BK, but now it's time to back them up. I think she can back them up.
Well, I mean, honestly, Kandy, you know, this is not Candy's first rodeo. Kandy has been, you know, Kandy has been around for a while. So I would actually take her saying that very seriously if I was in the women's division.
Hold on, BK, I'm getting word in my headset. We got another video.
I'm very much confused, really. Oh, another video? Okay.
Apparently.
Oh my god, what are we? Oh my god. Oh, look, flashlight, okay, come on. Yes! Oh my goodness, Miss Banshee! Are you there? Hello? Miss Banshee! If you're there, can you give me a sign? Banshee? Hello? I don't see anything. What's happening? Miss Banshee, if you're there, can you give me a sign? No, 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 no. No, 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 I don't want to deal with this. Oh, no, no. Why? Why did they shut? What is this? What is this? What is this? No! No, 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 Banshee, no! 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 No!
Krystal looking at the ref for to start counting her out. Just one, two, three, four. And it doesn't look like Brooke Owens might have hurt herself more there. At a five count now. Six. Oh, no. Allison Danes is outside the ring. Telling that she's too old for this. Well. Refs up to eight. Brooke Owens back in the ring. Right at the eight count. That's suicide dive, I think, BK and Samantha. I think that hurt her more than... I think it hurt Samantha more than it hurt Allison out there.
I don't know if I'd say that it... I don't know if I'd say that it hurt her more, but due to the fact that she's exerted a lot of energy and she has taken a lot of punishment, yeah, it probably took more out of her than what she thought it was going to.
And if you don't chase, then it's still a riskable move. You put a lot of energy on that and you have to pay the price.
See, Queen Krystal tried to go for that finishing maneuver, the K-bomb there, but it looks like Brooke was able to counter with a Frankensteiner.
Well, you've seen the match so far here, Samantha, with Brooke Owens. What are you thinking? I mean, you had Brooks in your sights here. Now you're getting a first bird's eye view here, first-hand look at Brooke in action. Here we go. What do we got here?
It's the Queen Decree.
Oh, that's her finishing move, too. She got both legs up. One, two. Oh, almost a three count there. And Brooke Owens stays alive in this match.
Unbelievable, really. There's still energy in Brooke Owens' tank.
Krystal, I don't know what else she can do here. Brooke Owens refusing to give up, refusing to take the loss.
Brooke has always had that no quit attitude, and that's helping her right now.
Oh jeez.
Oh my goodness.
And it went with a bicycle kick. And now with a bicycle kick.
Oh. In the pin, too. Here comes the ref. One.
Oh, my God.
Two. And three, and that'll do it.
Oh, my God.
Brooke Owens.
Here is your winner, the Black Swan, Brooke Owens.
Brooke Owens gets the win here. I mean, basically in a 2-on-1 match, but Allison stays outside the ring. Pretty impressive victory here from Brooke Owens to end our show. What a show we had here tonight. Yeah, I mean, it was a big win. I mean, like I said, it looked like it was like a 2-on-1 match earlier in the match, but she pulled it through and got the victory. Now she's in front of us. Well done there, Brooke.